All right.
Hi, everyone. I'm Steven. And for those of you who are in the HCI community and design community, our speaker today needs very little introduction. Hiroshi Ishii is a professor of media, arts, and sciences at MIT. He's also the associate director of the Media Lab. And Hiroshi's groundbreaking work on tangible user interfaces has in many ways changed the way we think about interaction between people and computers. His seminal 1997 paper on tangible bits really opened up a new domain for research and design, thinking about how to give physical form to digital information. Actually, there's a funny story about that paper. Our own Jim Holland was pretty instrumental in getting that paper accepted to Kai.
Thank you for your help.
Kai reviewers wanted to reject the paper on the grounds that it didn't have a very good user evaluation.
Yes.
But Jim argued that this would be the paper that everyone talks about. And in fact, he was right. Everyone did talk about the paper. And it has gone on to be one of the most cited papers, if not the most cited paper of all time from Kai. But what really excites me and inspires me is how Hiroshi's work blends the rigor of science with artistic expression. I think you'll get a sense for that in his talk today. And with that, please give Hiroshi a warm welcome.
Great. Thank you, Stephen. It's really exciting because I never exist here if my first Kai paper rejected. And that Jim Holland, also Mark Weiser, helped rescue me. But also, Mark Weiser really sent an amazing message saying, this is a paper of the vision of computation of 21st century. Even he wrote to me that UbiComp, name UbiComp, is abused. Many people put UbiComp. It doesn't have any more power. But the 100 bits is exactly what he envisioned. Why don't we use same banner to keep marching? That's something the most amazing message I got. It's a treasure. So today, I'd like to talk first old piece. Before life at MIT, I did a shared drawing stuff. And I was so fortunate that I was in Kai 92 in Monterey, in which Professor Jim Holland presented a seminal paper, Beyond Being There. Who wrote the paper? Not so many hands. You have a homework, Beyond Being There. And I thought, oh, that exact vision. I'm working, I'm trying to instantiate. So since then, Jim really inspired, encouraged me. So building an instance is something very important, but how to abstract the essence is very critical. So simply, how to integrate interpersonal communication space, like a video conferences, also whiteboard, shared learning surface. On other words, like a Google Doc and a Skype. How to interact seamlessly so that you can also read the gaze of your remote partner clearly. And gaze reading is something very, very important, nonverbal, but convey a lot of information about the engagement, attention. So we try to really remove the seam, which introduced by multi-window, splitting a face and a body. But also this provides gaze awareness, which often difficult when you draw together side by side. So that is one of the instances I really wanted materials, Jim's vision of Beyond Being There. I was in Kai conference last week. Who were in the Kai? Good, a lot of the hot, amazing discussion. The reason I really like that conference and the venue is many, many ideas colliding. Also, I see in the collision, I see a lot of new opportunities, disagreement, discussion, and critique. And finally, we see new discipline transcending. CSCW in 20 years ago is one of the kind of examples. So seeing those processes is something most exciting. So one of the key theme of today is how to really do transdisciplinary design, how to blend art design and science technology. So this is a summary of the notion of the transdisciplinary, but finding opportunity in conflict between the discipline. So collision is opportunity. Then breaking down old paradigm to create new archetypes. That's exactly what I've been doing in the past 22 years. And so I'd like to show a lot of the example. First, arts and science is something very, very important framework. And more specifically, let's take a music and technology as example. So playing, appreciating music, something very, very critical things in our life. So Xiao Xiao, my PhD candidate, designed with me called Mirror View to go beyond MP3 player. This is a bit homage to Clear World. You see the pianist shadows, also invisible hands with actuated keyboard. So she can be also in the piano playing with her, or her grandma, who used to be the concert pianist, can still live in the piano, then keep playing. So eternal life, embodiment of the musicians, but ghostly present musician exactly sitting in the same chair because of mirror reflection. So embodiment is something very important. Music is not a sound, vibration of air, whole the process, breathing, movement of the body, shoulders, everything conveying important information. I'm a calligrapher, but before first ink drop on the paper, already calligraphy started. It's an old dance. How to capture the movement of the body is something very, very important. Also, I'm excited about UCSD. Now you guys really building a new world, having a design as a core. I went to the Milano Design Week 2 years ago, and we exhibited one of the pieces which I'd like to show today, talk a lot later. Can I get a sound a bit higher? Oh, do I need to, can I get sound higher? Okay, so this is an instantiation to materials, my vision of radical atoms. Today I'd like to talk. Oh, thank you. So this is a future of the materials, which fully computational, physical, and interactive. So today, I'd like to talk why I'm keen to creating design new medium of the expression, design, and the communications. So this is a summary of my life in the past 25 years. It's a battle against pixel empire. Still, pixel empire dominate entire planet, TV screen, smartphone. Fundamental representation of digital information is a pixel stuck behind 2D screen. And the pixel is intangible. It's incompatible with the body. You have to depend on remote control, symbolic manipulations. Even touch screen, you're not touching information, just surface. So that's the reason 22 years ago, I started 100 bits, pushing information above water. So this is a physical world, this is a digital world. So partially, information is tangibilized, physically embodied, so you can directly grab using kinesthesia. But still, this tip of the iceberg is frozen, shy. So that I decided to go to the next level to make material dance, materials move, transform, also change the property like a stiffness, computationally. So that's radical atoms. Today I'd like to go very quickly compressing my 22 years world into the 55 minutes. So important engines over the vision. Technology really enables a lot of stuff. Also needs finding, solving the problem, applications very, very important. But fundamentally, most important is lifespan. Who cares? In 10 years, most of the technology you're using, your smartphone goes landfill in 3 years, definitely, even it's usable. Also, notion of the music consumption dramatically changes. But the vision, like Douglas Engelbart, collective intelligence, Ivan Sutherland, ultimate display, Mark Weiser, ubiquitous computing, this never disappear. It's continue to shine the path. So my battlefield is the boundary between digital and the physical. Then 20 years ago, I proposed 100 bits, very simple physical embodiment of digital information and the computation so that you can directly manipulate and grasp. So that also stimulated a lot of stuff by George Fitzmaurice's PhD thesis I did together in the University of Toronto of Grasspable UI. So let me show the first piece, old classic piece called the Music Bottles. Mm-hmm. So these are simple transparent glass bottles. But musicians or music is inside, like a genie bottles or perfume bottles. Once you open the stopper, the music is coming out like a perfume bottles. Aesthetics come not from the beauty of the skin or beauty of the surface, but also fragilities. Once you broke the bottles, you can't reboot, like life of us. So this project is a very personal project. I started to have my dream to give a birthday present to my mom. And she lived in Sapporo City, north part of Japan. But when she wakes up, she wants to check the weather forecast of today. Then we wanted to make bottles which tell her about the weather of today using a sound of the bus. She opened the soy sauce bottles many, many times to cook for me. That's the word she understands. But I never want her to use the machine that we use every day because this machine is completely irrelevant to her life. But she knows the world of kitchen, the bottles. But she passed away in 1998, so instead of the wizards, I start putting the music and the poem to explore the how we can make information more accessible using our love understanding of the warm physical world. And also this became a tribute to the Mark Weiser. His ubiquitous computing such a powerful paradigm, but how to make technology transparent, invisible, such a powerful notion, which really resonated about design. So I wrote a paper, Bottles as a Transparent Interface, as a tribute to Mark Weiser. Also, Mark Weiser really helped me to continue Tangibits as Jim Horan. I really appreciate it. Otherwise, I couldn't be here. Also, community of Tangibits didn't exist. So now I'd like to show different piece, eye brush. Who do painting, watercolor, or oil? Who has kids who do a lot of paintings? Oh, good. Anyway, so let me play the video. This is a PhD work of Kimiko Ryokai. She went to IDO and then went to the Berkeley. One of the origin is a Renaissance art. Artists in the Renaissance era were not only the painters, but also the color maker. They made their own pigment. If they need a beautiful purple, they went to seashore, collecting a purple seashells. They created the pigments. So we wanted to bring back this practice of color making, so that each color, texture, has a very special meaning, emotional meaning. So you can get any color from color picker, but this color is very special, emotional, have a meaning. And every stroke now has a story, meaning. You can explore the world. So Kimiko's PhD title is World as a Palette. Once you interact with eye brush, you can't stop dreaming what kind of painting you can do with a beautiful scenery of color leaves, for example. If you go to a Whole Foods market, you buy and eat fruits, but the beautiful color combination inspire the new creation. So it's very interesting to think about material chain, upstream. From where this color came from where this tomato you are eating came from, to extend the imagination to the upper stream. This project is something very exciting. And this using a painting as a metaphor, but to go beyond painting, this is a history mechanism to capture from where this color came from, its origin. This is something very important. But the most beautiful thing is kids doesn't care, MIT professor, he doesn't care my explanation of history. She came up her own interpretation. So this is a very important moment. She's so proud of to went beyond the imagination or expectation of designers. This is not a box. It's a painted brush waiting for the new interpretation of the world and the art piece. So these are photos I took in the Barcelona. And all the beautiful color palette of nature was exhibited in the old city. But the future kids who travel the world can find all the interesting inspiration from the world. They're using these materials, they express. That's something I dream. So core question of research is how to represent information, then how to interact. Representation already have important manipulator, operators. So aurora is one of my favorite objects because I care about astronomy a lot. So this is a beautiful machine. But the most important part is handle. This hand is inviting you to grab this with your hands. Once you grab, then start rotating. You are the part of the machine, your kinesthesia, bone, muscle, completely synchronized with the four seasons or movement of the planet around the sun. No ambiguity. This tight coupling, impedance matching, never happened in GUI because symbolic, abstract, indirect. Also, it's real 3D. People can come together, collocate it. It's not a fake 3D from one person point of view or HMD. So this is the beginning of Tangibits, and this is a paper that survived, thanks to Jim and Mark Weiser again. But I'm so happy because so many people read this paper, because it's not a paper about user study or system or technology, but very different idea about how physical world can be blended into digital world. So let me show the most, important project that my first PhD student, John Dockerfra, did.
Purpose are most complex, comprehensive application today, and is again intended for professional use, this time in the field of architecture and urban planning. Burke employs wireframe architectural models as the focus of a number of integrated simulations, including the generation of accurate shadows.
So we are fortunate because MediaLab is part of School of Architecture and Planning. We learn so much aesthetics and taxonomy. So this is a building, but the physical embodied, casting digital shadow, not optical shadow. But you can use two hands, simultaneous manipulation, or four hands, or six hands. Your colleagues are there. Space multiplex. Also clock become an inverse, input controller. So you can control the time of the, oh my gosh, sorry. Please have a short break. Okay, ignore. Okay, of course, ignore. I don't like it. But anyway, I recover quickly. So hope you can cut the videos, edit videos. But the important thing is physical embodiment really enable people to the direct operations so that you can really, you can the kinesthesia. So after the app, we did this urban planning project called Illuminating Clay, and also the soundscape. This project enables people to design the landscape, but also sculpt for giving a beautiful scenery. So let me show the videos of the from Ars Electronica in 2003. So it's a sandbox. Everybody played with sandbox. So form giving, it's very malleable materials. But while you're giving a form, it captures the shape. This is a water drainage, how water runs down the slope. The color shows the speed, so you can infer the erosion. So beauty of landscape, form giving, plus computationality together into tangible bits, because this is a physical material provides all the affordance sound, but also compute, then reflect. But the problem is this sound is frozen. Sound doesn't have memory about shape once shape is changed. How to bring back memory is one of the reasons we started radical atoms. So fundamentally, we try to hack the matters, materials. So today, the two materials as a designer or engineer, one is frozen atoms, like wood, metal, stuff, very passive. Another one is dynamic pixels, but intangible, stuck behind 2D screen. So I dream that the third materials is the radical atoms, which dynamic, physical, and computational. So today I'd like to show the history of the evolution, starting from the very simple crude prototype that Daniel Leitzinger did in his master's thesis. But the interesting stuff is this resembles the sand or clay, so that you can directly manipulate, but also remember the change of the shape, so you can really travel through the time to understand the erosion or mountain building, for example. So this is a, we try to change the meaning of rendering. Rendering is not any more pixel on screen, but the physically, also this is bidirectional. You change computational model, physical shape change, and vice versa. So one thing, but also you can use a mid-air gesture, for example. So inventing a new representation, inventing a new interaction, is a way we've been doing those kind of research. So then we want to go to the inform. Inform is done by Daniel Leitzinger, also Sean Former, together with tight collaboration, and got a lot of good design award. But the most interesting thing is people are so captivated in this application of telepresence. So this is another homage to CleaBoard. So now you can see, you can be San Diego, but also London together. Then you can manipulate the materials over distance. So this is one of the many potential of shape display. But it's not a display, it's a real machine, robot, manipulator. So we're very excited, but people really surprised to see that being here and there. And that's something Jim Horan really talked in Chi 92. So there are so many still room to go beyond being there, beyond the pixel, beyond the screen. And the sense of the presence really bring us to new levels. How many people saw this video before? Then you can sleep. Yeah. So definitely design something very interesting domain, but also the body become part of the shared landscape. This is also the intermaterial interaction is something very, very important, which we didn't notice when we did the first one, but now we can move things around. So that's the intermaterial interaction really open door to the next levels. Yeah. So in the CHI conference last week, this week, we presented a new project called Manipulable. Means you can now emulate flexibility, viscosity, elasticity, any material computationally. You can hit, push, pull, it behave. But also you can put the cheek, upper body, you can use all the skin to understand, interact. So it's really interface between your body and computational models mediated by these materials. So you can extrude the shape and give a form. Also, there are a lot of the interesting data visualization going, and also 3D printing. But the 3D printing is kind of a frozen atoms. Atoms are kind of dead. It's not anymore active. So this thing is sure, still data is active, computing, to satisfy certain constraints. So this is totally different. Printing is kind of dead end for me. How to really keep the constant computation behind seems sometimes very, very, very important for me and for us. And we also have a great opportunity to exhibit this piece in the Cooper Hewitt Design Museum. Who went to Cooper Hewitt to see this piece? Okay, but it came back to MIT, but this fall it go to Linz, Austria for Ars Tectonica. That we did a lot of interesting exploration because we're really interested about the new artistic expression. And we're very inspired by Escher. So this we call Escher mode. You can see that your life in a corporate maze. Well, but also you can explore the relative movement. So everything relative, environment and you yourself. So this exploration of how we can use this as a medium of the new expression, paintbrush. So putting three inform engines, we created a transform, also inspired by the triptych of the paintings, so that we made this system. And first, I'd like to show the video of the, all the contributors, including Daniel Leitzinger, Sean Former, talk about their passion. So there's three or four chairs available here. Please come. Are you okay?
Let's switch to the American English ones. How to integrate the beautiful aesthetics of the furniture and the tables as aesthetics of dynamic motions, like a machine constantly moving based on the data and energy?
Transformers about the simplicity of motion emerging from the complexity of the computational world.
He became a Stanford professor now.
So usually it's not just a static object, but we wanted to give it some kind of motion, to give it some life form, so to explore the interplay of static and dynamic, which we can achieve with these things that react to it, but also can display any content. We don't want the furniture to become even more important than the motion itself, but we still want to make it feel that it's a one unified design.
He's an amazing designer and fabricator in Israel. He has so many amazing work.
Complex machinery.
Daniel Reitzinger.
Motors that we need to control precisely with the computer. So for us, the biggest challenge was, instead of trying to hide the complex machine, we made it disappear through the beauty of motion.
So we brought this piece to the Milan, and that's very interesting because it's a design exhibition. Furniture is usually steel, frozen. The beauty is often surface or skin, but we try to make a collision of the beauty of dynamic motion on the engine. So let me show the videos. We wanted to tell a story of nature and the machine. So now you see the fishes swimming, then wave. So now you see structure coming out from the water. That a machine. Machine became jealous about nature because it's so beautiful. So machine tried to emulate, copy the beauty of wave. The machine is now developing a program, mathematical formula under the waters. So evolution algorithms is being evolved. Then you see it converge into certain different aesthetics. Machine also became envy because human being socialize, dance, eat together, tweet or Facebook. But radical atoms found friends. It's a frozen atoms, red balls. These red balls has no consciousness, computational consciousness, but they can dance together. The last story is ancient civilizations, BC 5000. There was a king. He built empire, city, castle. But his empire didn't last so long. Soon, his empire started declining. Then his castle turned out to be the sand castles. Nature came back and struck back. So in Milan, I talked to the young designer artist. This is one of million stories. This is equivalent of the new white canvas, paintbrush, ink, just invented. We need a Gogh, Picasso, Matisse, would you like to be? So that's the reason we're really excited creating a new medium of the expression and design. so that we can really open the door in a very interesting way. And also, I talk about the collision. So, Ars Electronica, sorry, Milan Salone is so famous, furniture, static floors. So I'd like to make a collision of dynamic motion engine using technology. Of course, atom of the bits. But also, Lexus collaborator have very beautiful philosophy, intriguing elegance through careful juxtaposition of opposing elements. So that's drove our design. And this is a team, and also we got a lot of nice awards. But this bit abstract and too artistic, and many people, especially from industry, asks, so what? So who care? I mean, so that I'd like to, we made a bit more illustrative future scenarios in which how, say, furniture or physical environment may change. Oh, by the way, this got the Golden Mouse Award. It's kind of ironical. Mouse represents GUI. We are fighting against Pixel Empire, but it's okay. Anyway, so this is fake. This is not real interactive one. We made a scenario, then made a transform dance according to the scenario. But to convey the possible idea, we never gamble, but for the sake of research to do fundraising, yeah. Anyway, we have no sponsor of the casino, but anyway. Also, socialization is something very important. So important thing is not specific application, but the people take for granted that the wood, metal, steel table are frozen. But once you know, you can progress the materials. Many interesting stuff, also scary thing can happen. So we are creating a new question, try to illustrate a new space of the possibility of design. So I think video prototyping is very, very powerful. And once you have a machine to illustrate those kind of the new behavior. So we've been talking about radical atoms, but the radicals have a lot of a new stream. And the last week, we have a five presentation, each address a lot of a new aspect. But now I'd like to talk about a new stream called polymer materials. It's very different from a shape display. So top is a shape display, controls all the pin, mechanically, electrically. These are like more materials, soft, squishy, transforming materials. So this is a new we presented in WISH 2013, and so let me show the videos. So we are using a pneumatic actuation and transformation by printing, fabricating materials, embedding all the structure transformation using elastic and non-elastic materials. You can make a desirable but the predefined transformation, pumping the air. Using this one, we started to explore a lot of the story, like a morphing form. Many years, I think Nokia did a concept video of the morphing form. But this is an homage to the app. Always sensing and actuation together, you can see the new texture appear. So these are new materials. You see all the pattern moving. So you can use the tactility, like a steering wheel. So we are exploring all these new dimensions, but also sucking air. You can do very different type of the transformation. This is like a yoga mat, but once sucking the air becomes very hard. Then soften, then harden, you can sit. So this is very rapid. So if you have a chair, table, but one interesting idea is if you have all the rolls of the carpet and the curtain connected, you can really download all the 3D shape, then give a form. But also you can soften any portion, then you can adjust it. So the room itself can have all the programmable furniture, for example. And also we did a collaboration with New Balance because softness, stiffness change is very important for runner or skiing, for example. How many people do skiing? Good. So you understand the top of the mountain and the bumpy slope and the end, you need to change a lot of stuff. But the latest project we started is called Biologic. Last year we presented, and we are inspired by the statement by Nicolas Negroponte, bio is a new digital, because now we can hack bio gene. So many projects resonated to this idea. So we took bio, could be the interesting new interface. So this is a message from human-machine interface to us, human living machine as a skin to the interface, like environment. So let me show the video of the biologic. So we found Bacillus subtusinato, that the bacteria become a great sensor of relative humidity, also actuator, so living bacteria. So we decided to cultivate. By the way, Bacillus subtusinato is a key for the natto, and I'm a Japanese. Who eats Japanese? Who natto? Who love natto? Okay, good. Anyway, so we're using natural phenomena of the bacteria to design, to transform into new materials. One of the striking beauty is it's grow. You don't need to soldering, you don't need to building, you don't write a code, but overnight, one cell becomes 10 billion. Then we make the solution. Also, we designed a special printer to print this solution liquid, which contain. So these are bacteria growing, observing in real time that how it grow. Also, we conducted tests. Atomic force microscope enable us to observe beautiful bacteria. We pick up favorite one, cute one, but then measuring all the stuff and using this solution as an engine. But to print on the fabric garment to make appropriate effect is very, very tough task, so that we need a very precise deposition. That also we presented this week called X-Print. This is a former bioprint, but the print exactly the right amount, right thickness of this bacteria to create desirable transformation when he and she dance and get sweat. So now you see another science of physiology. Each people have a different pattern of heat map, sweat map. So measuring this one, correlating with the New Balance, this science informed to the printers, then all the computer-aided design can simulate how much this transform, how much bacteria have to be printed, where. The last part is art. So this is an experiment. How can you bring science of the biology, chemistry, or physiology to the fabrication technology, but also computer design, then bring a new skin which breathes, then perform in the context of the art. So after this video we released, we did exhibitions in MIT Media, because last October, we celebrated the 30th anniversary of MIT Media Lab. So towards this ceremony, we constructed, we really like exhibitions. So we designed the furnitures. So how to tell a story is so important. For the design research, we have to invent, build, but also how to communicate is so important. This is a steamboat. Now you see that these bacteria dancing, transforming. You can really see it in real time. But also you can design many different shapes. Another layer, geometric computer design. So these are all the bacteria helping our research without any sleep. So this wired mannequin is very important symbolic structure. Then you can see this skin open and close based on the steam. So we invited our friends of Boston Ballet Company to this event. So we learned so much, but how to really communicate those ideas to the audience really requires the aesthetics, very strong message. And one of the important message is an important paradigm shift from building with controls, precision, engineer, to let it grow, or let it die, or let it dissolve. That's two different paradigms. This is incompatible, but if you bring design and art, you can connect them together. So one of the important themes is transdisciplinary, finding opportunities in conflict between disciplines, biology and computer science, for example, or technology and fashion design or furniture design. Deconstructing the old paradigm to create new archetypes, then transform beyond preconceived concepts. So that process we are repeating in the radical atoms. And the problem is people take the constant for granted. For example, gravity. But the gravity sucks because you're stuck on the floor. You can't use the space above. So we did a prototype called Zeron. It's a new material, anti-gravity materials. Three things you can do. You can put in the air, they stay there. Second, the computer knows exact location. Then third, the computer can move it. So these concepts are very powerful. Technically never scale up, but it's really interesting. If you make a furniture or whatever architecture, or today, I'm so delighted to see the blue house falling from heaven, stuck. It's so beautiful. I'm so impressed. Also, stone rock teddy bear, that's inspired me. I come so many new art ideas. But anyway, once you refuse to take it for granted, then question, what would happen? I can use a Zeron for my product design. Then you can really teach the planetary science, many things in a totally different way. This is Gina Lee and Remy's project. But it's very interesting for me to gain new perspective. Perspective is so important. I like astronomy, but our ancestors observed the universe using naked eye. Then they invented a telescope. Telescope is very powerful. But still, you have to stick your eyes, head, in telescope. Even become observatory, it's still stuck on the Earth, or your head. But the most important things happen when NASA deployed Hubble Space Telescope. It's like a decoupling your eyes, throwing to the universe. Then look back, look at the world, totally different perspective. Also, my favorite spaceship is Voyager, and also Pioneer. They went far away using gravitational slingshot, utilizing power, gravity of the planet, fly by, gain the speed, energy, changing the trajectory. That's something I've been doing, meeting Mark Weiser, Dan Engelbart, Jim Hollands, all the amazing Alan Kay, Nicholas. So anyway, by traveling far away beyond the solar system, now you can look back, you can see yourself in a totally different context. So the problem is people could only see the world from their own perspective or from the eye. But we have to really enhance and expand, even escape from constraints that we already took it for granted. And also very important thing is things changing so dynamically. So we need to really gain holistic perspective. But at the same time, also you need a heuristic focus. Where you should focus is very important. And in the last project, we focused on the bacteria. So I was very fortunate because 1994, I got an email from Alan Kay. I never met him, but he asked me to come to Atlanta to give a talk about the clear board. Then right after my talk, Alan Kay and Nicholas came to me, suggesting me to come to MIT. I was headhunted. And it's a 10 minutes coffee break, so let me think 10 minutes. Then I said yes. Anyway, that's a dramatic. That's a very dramatic change. And but after that, it's really amazing like experience for me, because it's very tough to coming up your own visions, having amazing genius peoples, but they inspired me. So important thing, the vision. We have to really envision what kind of future you really want to see, you want to leave for your descendants. But also you have to embody, you have to build it. To build it, you have to understand technology, design, and of course science. But most of the inspiration of the embodiment and the envision comes from the art or philosophy. And also when you bring some stuff, communicate, you have to bring back to the level of the art and the aesthetics, deep aesthetic matters. Otherwise, it doesn't stick, doesn't move or resonate. So now I realize art is so fundamentally so critical. So I have a special slide for the young designer or young researchers. I have a three driving force. These are nine characters in China. Who is a Chinese character or Japanese character? Good. I'm supposed to etch this nine character to my tombstone. But my wife said, I don't want to sleep in this tomb because I can't sleep well. So I explain. First stuff is standard. The nail that just pokes out, gets hammered down, stick out far enough that no hammer can reach you. How many people hit a hammer in the head? How many people can't even remember how much? Okay, anyway, so I think in certain society, you really care about homogeneity, equal, but sticking out is very important. This is one dimension. Second, two dimension, blazer trails. A true creator lives for the untouched terrain and run at full speed on the path, not yet born. There's no finish lines or stopwatch. You can run 100 meter track faster, somebody, but what is the track there, stopwatch there? Judge is there. That's not real competition, not real creation. So this two dimensions, second dimension, blazer trail. One thing I learned in MIT is when I got the offer from Nicholas, I thought I had to climb up high mountain, then peak of the mountain is hidden by the cloud. There's no map, no path, but it was totally wrong, completely wrong. There's no such things like a mountain. I had to build a mountain from ground zero, then climb up first, then let other people climb after that. That's only the reason you can survive. So I compress, form the peak, shape your own mountain from the ground up, and then ultimately be the first explorer to conquer this new summit. This is a message I give to the faculty candidate. So these are three like a message and the nine characters, but my wife refused to come to this stuff. Anyway, I'd like to really thank to today. This is a great opportunity because every day having Scott Kramer, all the friend, I have to show something new, but also inspiring, deeper. So I really appreciate today. And I have a plan to go different space very soon, 2050. But the most important things all together in 2100. Sorry, but that's reality. But the future never ends by your retirement or end of your life. It continues to exist. So I have a question keep asking myself. What do you want to pass to the those living in 2200? How do you want to be remembered? Or what do you want your legacy to be? That's the question I ask myself every day to my colleague, so that you can really understand what I have to do using precious time this year, this month, or today, or next 1 hour. So 2200 is a very important symbol for me, because life has set endpoint, but the future is never ending. For that future, we are responsible for. Also, we love technology, but every technology becomes so obsolete very, very quickly. But the vision, real vision, is everlasting. So thank you very much for your kind attention.